Kasha, mother of cheese. This is Everybody Eats.
Ooh, good job. Okay. I like that one.
That was cute.
Right. What's up, everybody? So, this week we all went to Harvey Ed's.
Correct.
Which is a modern take on a New York style deli located in the Short North area. The restaurant itself is, I won't call it small. It's like medium.
Moderately sized, yeah.
It's about medium size. Yeah. Parking wise, it's in the Short North, so you gotta just find parking where you can. You might even have to do a parking garage if necessary.
It sucks.
Yeah,
it sucks.
Parking does suck. Yeah, there's just no way around it.
Terrible.
But before we get into all that though, I mean, obviously you guys are our guests today.
Our guests are our mothers.
Right, for Mother's Day. Yeah, glad you guys to be here with us. First kick things off, what was your favorite Mother's Day gift that you've ever gotten from us?
Oh, for me, it was a photo picture frame. You and your brother did double photo on each side and recorded your voice on. I still have that. And if you press the button, it says, Happy Mother's Day, Mom, we love you. And yes, I can play that over and over again.
That's cute.
That's really sweet.
Mm-hmm. That's very sweet. I didn't do anything like
you
that.
You didn't do anything.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. We have the usual macaroni art, string art, but my favorite thing is just getting together with him and just hanging out. We don't do that a whole lot, so to me that's my favorite, and that could be Mother's Day or any day.
She made me sound like a terrible child.
I try. I have so much to work with.
I mean, it's okay. Yeah.
I was trying to say she loves you.
That's right. I love you. And I like to be with you. I like to hang out with you.
And that's what motherhood is all about. So the next question is, with the way we are now, how does that compare to how you envisioned us growing up as kids?
You are exactly the way you were from birth, very sure of what you want and didn't want.
Mm-hmm.
Still, that stands, but you're, I guess, a little bit more developed now, refined.
Yeah.
I guess after spending all that money to college, and that should happen.
Right.
Fair. Ideally.
Right.
Let's see here.
I don't remember my childhood.
I know you don't remember some things. No, you are exactly the way you were. Also, I mean, when you were a baby, you didn't sleep much ever.
Sleep all the time, though.
Yeah,
but you still do it in like weird increments. Didn't really sleep much. Very picky about his food, everyone. Always. Very picky about his food and what he wanted. And he will still let you know nice and plainly what it is that he wants. So nothing has changed.
And I used to eat everything when I was
there,
right?
Yes, you did. I couldn't find anything that you didn't like to eat, even though there were things I thought you probably wouldn't like. Once you tasted it and you ate every single thing that you ever tasted.
Never changed.
Never changed.
I stay consistent.
We didn't have quite that experience. Christian, you just like to challenge me with things. Do you remember sitting there with the green beans?
I do not.
You do not. I would ask him to please eat one green bean, please.
Begging.
Because he ate oatmeal 3 times a day, every day, for at least 2 years or more.
Look, I don't know if you ever had dinosaur egg oatmeal.
It's by Quaker, he really loved it.
It goes crazy.
Yeah.
It's bigger.
So that's all he wanted. So I would literally try and get him to eat a vegetable. So it was like, okay, let me chase him down. So I was like, look, if you eat one of these green beans, then I will give you some more oatmeal. And then it would be like, then I waited, you know, like a week. Okay, if you eat three of these green beans.
Dinosaur egg.
Yes, and now though, what is funny is, picky as he was, he will eat anything you put in front of him now. He will try anything and everything.
Yeah.
And I love that.
It all started with three green beans.
I was the catalyst.
Okay. And I think lastly what I was going to ask is, what is your favorite memory you have of us from our childhoods?
There are many. I know. I have many to pick from. One really crazy one was, I was called to come to the door to watch this by your brother and some neighbor kids. Come see this, you've got to see this. And I went to the door and looked out just to see you running up the driveway. You ran straight up the front of the SUV and up onto the top of the SUV. You were three.
Oh my God.
And I nearly had a heart attack. And everybody jumped up and down, yay, he did it! And I'm looking like, oh my God, he did that. Don't do it again. Don't ever do that. And they were all just cheering, and I'm like, okay, yeah, that's not what I thought I was coming to see.
Totally not.
I know.
They were all just roaring, yes, he did it. Like it was some wonderful thing. And I'm like, no, no, nobody should ever do that. Nobody do that again.
Okay, that's a good one.
But you felt victorious. You stood up with your fist up and everybody was cheering and they thought it was quite wonderful and I was terrified.
3-year-old little Superman.
Yeah, you know.
Daredevil here.
Yeah.
Could do anything.
Yeah. No.
That's cute.
It is cute. With you, it's not quite the same, but at your daycare center, they would have like a family day and they had a festival.
Oh,
and
okay. Yeah.
He was about,
actually, I remember that.
Okay, he was about three. And they had this climbing wall, which, okay, fine. I don't think you'd ever done it before that day. As far as I know, you hadn't. And so they have us sitting out there and it's, I'm like, okay, I'm not paying him any attention. He's running around, having a good time. And it's like, first Christian. And someone's always like, he's up there. And I'm like, and I'm looking and there are like, you know, older kids that are like way down here that can't get as high as he can. He made it all the way to the top. There was a bell he rang and stood there like, look at me. And it was, I was the whole time I'm going, I was gonna get down. He made it up and I'm like, I was gonna get down. I was like terrified. You know, your dad was standing there like, I'm gonna catch him if you fall. Oh my God, I'm gonna have to catch him if you fall. And you know, that is the way your dad is.
Did you make it back down?
And he didn't fall, he didn't slip. But everybody was like so proud of you. Like, can you believe that little guy did that? And I was just like, yeah, actually, I guess I can. I can.
I thought you were gonna tell a totally different story.
Which one did you want me to tell?
No, I just thought you were gonna tell a different story.
No, I just came up with that one for now. All
right. Yeah. I'm gonna roll with that.
You're right. Okay. Well, thank you guys for answering those questions.
Anytime.
Yes, we appreciate it. So yeah, like I was saying, we went to Harvey and Ed's. It's in the short north, moderate sized restaurant. The interior, when you walk in there, with it being a modern restaurant, it's very just nice looking. They had some kind of like chandeliers, right?
Yeah, I wasn't paying much attention.
Yeah.
Overhead lighting.
Yeah.
Yeah, overhead lighting.
Really nice.
And they had like mirrors and TVs. It just looked really nice.
They had like a deli counter. It was selling like cured meats and fish and things of that nature. I also noticed that there was like a thing with like, I don't know, it was like not Mr. Piv in there or something, but like a soda thing.
they had a New York seltzer in there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They had new, and I hadn't seen that in years. I used to see it all the time.
Yeah.
And that's the one thing that caught my eye, because I was like, oh wow, they have that. I haven't seen that. But yeah, they have that. And there were other drinks in it too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's
really
nice.
Nice. So, we get seated, and I think we just started with our cocktails. For me, I had the Negroni, which was comprised of Benham's gin, Campari, and sweet vermouth. It was good, definitely bitter, but I really liked the taste of it, so I enjoyed the drink. But my mom also tried some of it.
It was good. It was, it was like a little bitter, citrusy, but it had a good taste.
Yeah.
It was good.
Okay. And how about we go down the line here? Dessert,
you can go.
Let me go. Okay. He knows her now. Black y'all. I had the Minch.
The real Minch.
Uh-huh. That's right. It was made with fresh ginger, honey, lemon, and monkey shoulder scotch.
Monkey shoulder scotch,
yes. And it was very good. It was balanced perfectly. Everything blended really well. It was kind of refreshing, actually. You tasted it.
Yeah,
I thought it was kind of refreshing, but it was really good. It was nice.
All right, cool, yeah. I had Ed's Martini. It had, botanist gin, what is it, sweet vermouth, and just a pickleback. Just really simple. I don't know, martini is like slowly sipping a shot, honestly. The pickle juice like came on the side, or like a pickleback should. It was really good. They do a lot of their pickles in-house there, so I'd imagine that's probably where that pickle brine came from. It was great. I don't know what else to say.
I tasted the brine, it was really good. The pickle batter, I didn't take a sip of that. It was really good. Mm. I was surprised, actually. I was expecting it to be more sour or something, a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Really good
food. Oh, my drink was the Benzin, Cantera, Nebra, Silver Tequila with blackberry and bitters. It was a nice, mellow, even keel, smooth drink. The blackberry was just enough flavor. It didn't kind of take it over, but it was good. I enjoyed it.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I like your vocabulary use. It was very in depth. Okay. So those are our drinks. For our appetizers, I had the, the Brussels sprouts, which had aged goat cheese, walnuts, grapes, pumpernickel, and mustard vinaigrette. So these were probably more of the intricate. This is one of the more intricate Brussels sprouts I've ever had in my life, not necessarily mean they're the best tasting, but I just like how they had a nice blend of flavors with them. So I like them a lot. So.
Yes, they were. I enjoyed yours too. The Brussels sprouts were good. Tender, just blanched kind of. I had the hummus, and it had a layer of pickled cabbage, crispy chickpeas, slices of warm pita, and mustard vinaigrette, which was done very well. It actually tasted really kind of like semi sweet.
It says vegetable. You looked the wrong thing. It says vegetable.
Oh, I looked at the wrong thing.
Yes.
That was yours.
You're right.
Yours had the mustard vinaigrette. Mine had the veggie de crudité.
There you go. Crudité.
There we go.
Yes, but yeah, it was very good. It was a very well seasoned, and they make their hummus there on site. It was a good texture and taste.
Okay. I have the matzo cracker.
That's your
entree. I'm sorry, that is my entree. But I'll get back to it because I really did have it. I have the latke royale. Latke is like a potato pancake. It's usually fried whenever I've had it. It had creme fraiche, house cured salmon, fennel, green apple, and that was pretty much it for me. You could also get it though with caviar on top as well, which I skipped. It was really, really good. I thought it was excellent. It was actually my favorite appetizer. We all kind of spread it around, you know, tasted everything. And that one actually was one that was my favorite, I do think. And I thought it was really good. Mm-hmm. And it was nice portion size. It wasn't too big. It wasn't, you know, it was just, you know, just what you needed.
Yeah.
Just a good appetizer.
I had just a knish, which is essentially just like puff pastry. And it had like, it's essentially like stuffed pastry with. A knish would be just essentially just like a stuffed pastry to some extent. It was like puff pastry with Gruyere cheese in it. If you're not familiar with Gruyere, it's just like a French version of Swiss cheese. That's about it. It's really simple. It was really good. I don't really know. It was bread. It's bread and cheese with like creme fraiche on the bottom. Can't really go wrong.
It's just so good. It was flaky.
The pastry was nice and flaky.
Yeah, the pastry was really flaky.
Yeah, they apparently really enjoyed it.
They're all so
We're
flaky.
We're thinking about the pastry. We like pastry.
Right. It was a buttery, crispy,
flaky.
The wine is baked in a buttery, flaky crust.
Baked on a buttery, crust.
Close.
Baked on a buttery, crispy crust.
Damn. That cool? Flaky.
I thought it said flaky. I'm okay.
You should have had me do that.
Oh yeah, she does that good.
Baked in a bake. Oh.
You boy.
All right, so those were our appetizers. As far as entrees go, I had the seared salmon, which was simply just salmon, garlic, roasted potatoes, and vegetables. You can never really go wrong with salmon. I've never really had a bad one myself. So, I mean, it was good. It was up to, it met my expectations. The vegetables were, in my opinion, seared pretty good. So, it's a all around just good entree.
Yes, I had the Zaid's brisket dinner, which had included glazed carrots, Brussels sprouts, creamier potatoes. They were like little roasted potatoes, but softer. Buttered pearl onions, and had a sherry reduction in it, which was very tasty. The brisket was really tender, and it was delicious. I liked the whole thing.
Okay. I'm gonna start over now and tell you what I actually had for my entree because I didn't realize what it was. I had the monster cracker crusted whitefish, which came with mashed potatoes, glazed carrots, pearl onions, and green beans in a lemon caper butter sauce. And I really, really enjoyed it. I was a little leery at first because sometimes, no matter where I go, I'm picky and my fish sometimes will be too dry. And I have an issue with that. But that, if it, you know, with the lemon caper sauce, with the butter sauce, it was like a perfect complement to the matzo crust that was on the fish. The vegetables were, you know, they were tender, they were blanched, nothing too soft, too hard, and just, you know, I felt like it, all around it was a really good entree.
Yeah,
fish
was good.
Yeah.
It was pretty solid.
It was really good. It was, the consistency of the fish was not just right.
Right.
It was nice and flaky and tender, and yeah,
it was overdone. It was perfect, yeah, because lots of times, you know, it's overdone, or I put underdone once,
yeah,
it was awful.
I had the meatloaf. Pretty simple. It was just meatloaf, mashed potatoes, green beans, carrots, and gravy.
But it was good.
It wasn't just any meatloaf.
No,
That was serious meatloaf.
It had like really nicely done seasonings in it. It was cooked well. And it had the little crispy a little bit on the outside and had that nice.
Tell me more.
It's about as much as I would expect to pay for at a, like a modern, like, you know, restaurant with, you know, you have a $20-ish entree and, you know, $8-$9 cocktail. Like it, everything seemed fairly priced, like not expensive, but not necessarily cheap either. Mm-hmm.
It looked like cocktails were what, like 8 to 12 entrees? Yeah. Entrees around, what, like 16 to 30 or so?
Yeah.
So like, you know, normal restaurant prices.
Yeah.
Nothing crazy.
Definitely affordable if you just want to go out and have a nice, you know, have a nice meal.
Yes.
Without worrying about it.
It was too full for dessert.
The portions were nice. They were like perfect.
Nice and filling.
Cool. Okay. Right.
You guys are killing it.
Yeah.
I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm probably staring at a light.
You're doing great. So if I were to give Harvey and Ed's a final rating, I would give them a... I'll give them a 3.25 out of 4 stars. I really like the ambiance. Service was good. With the food, all the food tasted good or great, but I don't think there was necessarily one thing that was just like excellent, where it was just like mind-blowingly great. But that's not to say like, you know, anything was bad by any means, because it was all, like I said, really good.
I don't know, man, I had the meatloaf
with meatloaf.
Right. That's true, but yeah. No, I think, yeah, I'm gonna go to 3.25. So.
I would say a good solid 3. Everything was good. There was nothing to complain about. There was nothing like out of this world amazing, but yes, everything was cooked well. Service was very good. And the atmosphere was nice and enjoyable, where we were just kind of sitting enjoying at the table eating.
Y'all were singing songs?
Yeah, they were singing songs.
Yes. That's right. Yes. The music was really good.
Yes.
Great.
Mm-hmm. It was really good. Everything was, it was good. So I would say solid. It wasn't like, you know, out of this world, like, oh my gosh, but it was great. It was really, really enjoyable.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I think I would probably give it a 3.25.
Okay.
It was partially because of the wait staff and the atmosphere. That is just a big deal to me personally. And the food, as I said, I enjoyed everything that I tasted, and we all tasted each other's food. I loved it all. The only reason it's 3.25 is because, you know, like as we said, nothing actually stood out so much, at least nothing that we ordered, stood out so much that it was, you know, mind-blowing, like, oh my god, I have to have this, I have to go here, I have, you know. So, but it was really, really good. So, you know, there's no way I would go under that. So, I think 3.5,
mm-hmm.
I think it's 5. I'm sorry, 2.5.
Yeah.
3.25, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
It was good.
time. I like spending time with Chris and, mm-hmm. and Cheese here. Mm-hmm. And it was lovely meeting you. So yeah. It was just a nice evening. You know, it was just a real nice evening. Eating, drinking, having yeah. fun, talking, making a fool of myself.
But and if I had to give birth over again, I would I'd do it.
Yeah, I would.
Okay.
I must say though that he is my youngest child.
As well.
We broke the mold, said okay, we're done.
Done.
Alright guys. Well, thank you for watching this week's episode. Catch us next week. Make sure you tip your servers as always.
Tip your server.
Happy Mother's Day to all of you and your mothers as well.
Happy Mother's Day to you.
To you. Congratulations to everybody that's graduating.
Auntie.
Also.
Yeah, that's your mom too.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, your mom that's also your dad. All that.
All that.
Everything.
Everybody.
Just go hug somebody.
Yeah.
Give
a
hug, baby.
Oh.
My baby. All
right, guys. We'll see you next week.
All right.
Peace.